Don't stress, there is more where that came from a bit later on in the show. Don't say we don't treat you. So listen, as we might have mentioned, tonight's show actually started in Dublin and we saw some major talent. So let's talk about some of our other contestants. Let's talk about Niall Sexton. The judges completely loved him. Bob, what was your thoughts on Niall?
Joe, I love the song choice. I think it's a little cutie, and he's just got that little... He's got, and it sounds so cliche being on The X Factor saying it, but he has got that razzmatazz, and I feel like, has he got the X Factor? He's got a little summit. You know, if he's like sprinkled glitter on someone.
I loved him. I thought he was great.
Yeah, you I would him. Eat him up. I love him.
Oh, all right, Bobs.
Come on, girl.
Not him. Charlotte, you liked him.
Oh, I thought he was really cool. I didn't expect him to be good, though. He looked like a bad one.
Well, do you know what? Simon...
Did he?
Simon said he had a beautiful and classy voice. Now, you are a girl who literally reeks class, Charlotte. You really, really do. Did you appreciate the vocals?
Yeah. They were so classy.
Really convincing. Tiger, he sang Gravity, and Nicole said she felt every single word of that song. What did you feel through the performance?
Well, just in a relevant strain of conversation, I'm actually reading a fantastic book about anti-gravity at the
moment. Oh, lovely.
And it's brilliant because it's absolutely... it's impossible to put down.
Right.
But anyway, do you know what? I thought his vocals were amazing. I thought he was really, really good. The song choice was great. If I could give him... Not that I can sing, but if I could give him any sort of improvement, I think he looked at his stage presence. He looked a little bit like one of those guys who's standing against the chain link fence in the playground, just about to be the last one picked for the school football team.
Oh, do you know what I mean? That's nerves, Tiger.
That's what I'm just saying. He's got such a good voice. If he just had a bit more confidence in his stage presence, I think he'd be 100% X Factor.
Well, do you know what? We are going to talk about Noel in a minute, but ladies and gentlemen, we had a returner on the show tonight. Xtra challenge 2 years ago and he swapped her out, a bit awkward, but he did admit that he made a mistake and she sailed through the room auditions tonight. Bob, Nicole said, I dig you. Did you dig her?
Oh, I was digging like a JCB. Oh! But the girl, she can sing amazing. She's got eyes like just incredible. I kind of fell in love with you, babe. Obviously, I'm on the other bus, do you know what I mean? But I was a bit like that, Janet. I ain't gonna lie.
She was a bit like that. Shah, from her audition, let me ask, can you see her doing well in this competition?
Very.
Has she got what it takes?
I think she's diverse.
Oh! It's a big word.
I know.
Go on, girl. Touch me.
I think she can sing any type of song.
You think she's quite,
so
you know, diverse with her range?
Through, yeah.
AR. How hard, though, this is the question of the night, do you think Simon took it to have to admit that he was wrong, Tiger? Because we don't see that a lot on this show, Simon admitting that he's wrong.
I mean, Simon Cowell is a very successful man. I don't think he would often have to admit he's wrong to many things, so it would have taken a lot for him to admit that. But I think he was right, because I think you were stunning, girl.
AR. But listen, as you saw as well, Dublin also had its fair share of duds, shall we say. Let's discuss poor Peter Richards. We've got to talk about Peter. You don't want to be classed as Bono, all right? No one mention Bono. Bob, did he prove to you that he could be an artist in his own right?
No.
No.
I mean, God loves a tryer.
Yes.
But for me, if it was like an X Factor where it was all about lookalikes, he would win it.
Yeah,
but when
it
comes to the voice, I just think, oh, he's missing something. But I'm sure on a Tuesday night in the local pub, he's going to smash it.
Well,
after the pub quiz.
You say this, that he might smash it. We don't know what he gets up to on a Tuesday night, but I've got a secret to share with all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Because Peter didn't only sing You Two. No. He also sang, wait for it, Ness and Dorma, ladies and gentlemen. Ness and Dorma. Now, this is what the song should sound like. It's not. And I can exclusively show you, this is Peter's version. You're welcome.
Mum, you're misty like yours, I'm mine. You know me on a sense of pro. No, no. So what will be holy Kayla, dear old?
Peter, this is really not working out well.
You have just got to love him, Bob. You really have. Well, listen, as you just saw, over in our audience, we have got Kaylee, Noel and Janet from tonight's show. Give them a round of applause. You nearly moved Simon to tears. You've just seen your audition back. How are you feeling right now?
I am feeling absolutely amazing. Like, who doesn't want to make Simon Cowell cry? Like,
well, some people have had their reasons, but for other reasons. What's the reaction been like? You've obviously had your phone, it's just gone out.
It's like I had to turn it off, it's not stopped. Literally, I'm so overwhelmed. I just want to say thank you to everyone.
Oh, no, it's a pleasure to have you here.
It really is.
Noel, I've got to come to you. These guys absolutely loved you. But there was one person in particular that fell in love with you, and that is our very own Nicole Scherzi, ladies and gentlemen. How does it feel to have a pussy doll as, like, your own fan?
I don't know. I still don't believe it. Like, someone who's had that much chart success in the music industry, I just want to say I wish I had a girlfriend that was hotter.
No! Oh! And don't you wish you had a girlfriend that's hot like her? Janet takes guts to come back to this show. It does, to return to this show, Janet. It really, really does. Was it easier this time for you?
It was, and then it kind of feels like going into a room and seeing your ex-boyfriend for the first time.
So hello, like, babe.
But it went all right, I think.
Well, I think it went very well. Everyone here is enjoying it. What are we making of our contestants tonight?
I quite like Niall because he was different from all the other boys. Like last week there was Ryan and Chris.
Yeah.
And they all were not same, but they were quite poppy, and then Niall was different.
Niall, we'll take that. We'll take that. Well, listen, guys, thank you for your chats. We're going to be speaking to you a bit later on. But give it up for our ex-contestants, everyone. We love them. Now, listen, the eagle-eyed lot of you out there will have noticed there was, unfortunately, a little tiff tonight between Louis and Simon. Yeah, there was. And it was all over who said no to One Direction's Niall at his very first audition. Let's have a little reminder.
The last time we were here was 6 years ago.
We got Niall from One Direction. Here we go.
You said no, I think, to him.
No, I said yes. Katy Perry said no.
Well, wait for it. You're actually both wrong. It was neither Louis or Katy Perry that said no, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. So, who could it have been? Audience, any guesses who it might have been?
Simon.
Someone said... Right, well, do you know what? I'm going to settle this once and for all. Who was it?
Simon, yes or no?
Well, I'm going to say yes.
Gerald, yes or no?
I'm going to say no.
I'm going to say yes.
Of course, you're in.
Nearly stopped Noel from being in One Direction. Actually, Cheryl could have potentially stopped One Direction from being a thing. She could have.